It's your girl, Chloe, from Chloe and Coco Mania! Today we are gonna be making a lobster bisque soup. And the one who's helping me today is my dad.
Hey, what's going on, everyone? How you doing?
This is a follow-along video. So grab your mom, your dad, and let's go. We got all our ingredients here. Our spices, our vegetables, and of course, the star of the show, the lobster.
Hello, Mr. Lobster. You are gonna be so yummy in our tummies. I think I'm gonna name you Leo. Leo the Lobster. Leo, listen. I'm sorry that your life has to end so soon, but I promise we are gonna make you a delicious, scrumptious meal.
So, are you ready to go, Dad?
I am ready. Are you ready?
Yes!
All right, let's get it. All right, so first thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and get your lobster. I've already pre-terminated our guy here.
Bye, Leo!
Bye!
Bye,
Leo!
All right, so pretty much it takes about 14 minutes for a lobster to really cook. So what I did is I went halfway because, as you'll see as we go through on the video, we're gonna go ahead and continue to cook the lobster in our bisque, as well as saute some of the meat as well for our stock, but you'll see exactly what's going on. So first we wanna do is go ahead and get a knife, all right?
And cut every piece.
That's right, Chloe, we're gonna cut every piece, all right? So what I'm gonna do is here, we're gonna go ahead and get the tail gone, all right? So you're gonna take your knife here. Any knife will work, but I like a sharp knife myself, all right? You wanna go ahead and turn it up here, and let's start to get in that head. All right, and as you get in the head, some juices will fall out, but that's okay. All right, and voila, pull that thing right out. All right, there it is.
There it is.
All right, so there's your tail. All right.
You got your tail there.
Let's go ahead and remove our claws as well. A quick little snap will do. Peels right, comes right off there. Go ahead and grab one, Chloe. Yep, just pull it. There you go, girl. Good stuff, all right? So there's your claws there. That's some great meat right there, look at that. All right? And also too, take a look there, you got a little vein in there. I'll clean that a little bit later, but you wanna also make sure you get your vein, your guts out there, okay?
That's really all right. Important.
Gotcha, right, it is important, Chloe. All right? So we're gonna go ahead, next thing we're gonna do is just pull that head right off. You don't need the head. All right, so I'm gonna go right in here and pull that head right off.
Pass the legs.
All right, get your knife in there. Go ahead and pull it up.
All the meat's right in there. A lobster has plenty and plenty of meat.
All right, that head you don't need, so we'll go and discard the head. All right, there we go.
We don't need that.
All right, so next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my body here. Got plenty of meat in here. I'm gonna go ahead, take this on over to my sink real quick, and let's give it a good rinse. Get all these nastiness out real quick. So Chloe, why do you like lobster so much?
Because they always crawl, and they're always so funny with their eyes, and I always like all the antennas, and the mostly thing that I like about the lobsters is All the meat.
Yeah, I love lobster meat as well. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make our stock that's going to go into our lobster bisque. So we need a few ingredients here, Chloe. So we have some ginger. You love ginger, don't you?
Yes.
All right. We have fresh garlic.
Garlic.
All right. We have
leaves.
Some bay leaves. Yeah, some bay leaves. And a nice yellow onion. Right, exactly. So let's go ahead and cut our onion in half, because we're gonna need the rest of it later.
Here's a fact. Ask your grown-up for help.
Always ask your grown-up for help. That's right, Chloe. Here's your onion as well.
So you see, My dad just cut in all those onions, so you're gonna put that all in your bowl where the garlic is and the ginger.
All right, and then last but not least, we have our bay leaves. All righty, perfect.
Don't forget to put the bay leaves in the bowl as well, too.
All right, so let's take it over to the stove. You ready?
Right.
Let's go. All right, so now we're over here at our stove. Let's go ahead and we already have our boiling hot water. All right.
Put that into there?
Yep, we're gonna go ahead and carefully, let's put, all right. All right, perfect. Here we go, all right.
Get all that steam going.
All right, that's awesome. Now what we're gonna go ahead and do is cover that back up. Go back over and let's go ahead and get our lobster head. Now remember, when we had our lobster head, we went ahead and we cut that out, okay? And so we cleaned it real good, got all that stuff out of there. So right now it's just meat. We wanna go ahead and give that bisque a good flavor. So we're gonna go ahead and put, what is his name, Mr. Leo?
Yes.
Leo Lobster into our stock. All right, let's go ahead and add him into our stock real quick. All right, one more time, let's go, go ahead. Go ahead and be safe here. Grab our mitt. Go ahead and add that in there, please. And we'll just go ahead and drop him in there. All right, you wanna make sure you go ahead and add him, give him another 10 minutes on that just to get that aroma going. Turn the heat down to a low and then let that just go for itself. Let's go back over and do some more things. Come on, Chloe, bring it back. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's begin to do our actual bisque, the base of our bisque, okay? All right, so I have some extra onion left over here that I'm gonna use to puree into my bisque, so let's go ahead and add that in now, Chloe, all right? Go ahead and add right over there. Go ahead and add that in your bowl, all right? All right, so we have three peppers for your consideration here, all right? You have your red, your orange, and your yellow, all right? No particular reason, just gives it a good taste, good flavor, and goes from there. All right, seems like the onions got your eyes watering, huh?
Yes.
That's what onions are supposed to do, but it's okay. All right, Chloe, go ahead and add these in there for me. Those are our red peppers.
Red?
Yeah. Let's go ahead and cut our orange peppers. Go ahead and add our spices, Chloe. Sounds good?
Good.
So what we're using today, we have some Old Bay garlic and herb. All right, go ahead and pop that open. You can use the rest of that. Just dump it all on there. Sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle. All right. There you go. Good deal. All right. Next we have maybe some garlic pepper as well. All right, go ahead and sprinkle a little bit on there, on that side there. Go ahead and sprinkle, sprinkle. That's good. Alright, we also have some garlic powder as well. Alright. And we're gonna have a little bit of kick, a little backyard southern style original we sell here at one of our local grocery stores. So we'll go ahead and add that on there as well, Chloe. Give that a little spike. There you go, that's good stuff. Thank you. Alright, good deal. So there we go for that. So let's give it a little mix, Chloe, and mix up those flavors there for me, please. Alright. So while that's going on, I'm gonna go ahead over here and I'm gonna go ahead and get my pan here going. And I'm definitely probably gonna go with at least about a half a stick of butter in my vegetables. Then I'm gonna saute them up and add some more ingredients in there. So go ahead and add that now. And I like to use real salted butter, all right.
Guys, here's a fact. When you're mixing all of your peppers and your seasoning, you need to use a food grabber to like mix and get all that seasoning spreading around and just do it like this.
All right. So I haven't forgot about our stock over here. So it's been about 10 minutes and man, I wish you guys could really see what this stock is looking right here. Let me see if I can make that happen. Doing that, let's go ahead and add it over here, Chloe, okay?
All right. Soon, we will be adding these vegetables into that blender.
First, we're gonna saute them first, and then we're gonna make that.
Look at that. Make sure to do it with the butter on the pan to let it bubble and fix. Like that.
Alright, give that a rinse, please. Alright, so now that we got our vegetables going over there, we're gonna let those simmer down, let all those seasonings and everything marinate in there. We're gonna go ahead and start taking our meat out of the rest of our lobster here. So we have our lobster tail. I usually start at the bottom and turn it around. And I just take a knife and go right up there. All the way up to the top. All right.
That's that meat.
All right. And then basically at that end, I'd separate it a little bit. Take my two hands here. Make sure everything is out of there, which it is. And I go ahead and I just pull it out. I got it, Chloe. This is a little tight.
That's all that things that you need to take out.
Yeah.
Get all that meat.
Don't be afraid to break that meat. There it is. Crack that shell. And there's that meat. There it is.
That's good.
Nice juicy meat.
Put it in the bowl.
Next, we got our claws here.
You break them.
Let's go ahead and get that meat out of the claws.
Juice will may fall out. And here's an important fact. You must be really, really careful with those claws.
Alright.
Claws. Because the claws has sharp pointy forms on them and they might hurt you. So be extra careful.
Let's go ahead and pull that right out. Little lobster. Alright.
Alright guys, so we are going to be putting our stewed tomatoes on our vegetables.
Yep. So,
let's go
grown up
for help.
There you go. So you got onions in here, butter, half a stick of butter, red peppers, yellow peppers, orange peppers, and now we're gonna add some stewed tomatoes as well. All right, throw that away for baby. Thank you.
It smells so good.
It does, it smells delish.
Exactly like
it smells very delish. And so once that comes to a little bit of a nice consistency there, we'll go ahead and add a couple more ingredients now.
Yes.
Most people use flour as their next ingredient into their bisque. I'm gonna use something called Lefty Spices. We get it at our local grocery store. Yeah. Check out Walmart and other grocery stores in your area for it. We use it on our fiction chicken. It's a great way to fry things, but I like to use it in my bisque, change it up and spice it up a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit in there. And that's gonna give it a little consistency and thickness. All right. Once that done,
mix
give
it
a little
up.
Stir and a little mix. Go ahead, Chloe, mix that up for me real nice, please. Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Put that back there. All right, so while Chloe's doing that, out of my stock, I have my head. And I'm gonna go ahead and start getting the meat out of that head to put into the vegetables. So now I have my head out of my stock. I'm gonna go ahead and take my meat off of my head here. Get all that meat out of there. I'm gonna go ahead and get them out of the claws as well. Out of the legs, I should say. And I'm gonna add this into my vegetables along with the vegetables that was in my stock. Now, I like to puree a little bit of lobster meat in with my vegetables, give it a little bit extra flavor there. But you could do it either way. Some people add it back into their stock and leave it, the thick chunks in there. I like to blend it all together, just a little something different. But whatever your preference, go for it. How's it going over there, Chloe?
It's going really well. The vegetables are fizzing, and the tomato sauce is blending in. It's going super good.
Sounds good.
And all of the flour is gone.
All right. So once we go ahead and get all your meat out of your head, I like to take it over here and just add it to my vegetables. I like that little flavor in there, okay? Let's go, Chloe. Let's put it in there, sprinkle it around. And this is what we're gonna give a good blend to, all right? Now you remember our stock over here. We still got some pieces in that stock. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is go ahead and take out vegetables, bay leaves, ginger, the onion, all that great exciting flavor.
And
I'm gonna put it right into our vegetables over here. All right, Chloe, stand behind me to my left. Okay, so now that I have all of my vegetables that were in my stock out, we're gonna go ahead and add that, we've already added it to our vegetables here with our lefties and flour ingredients there that we put in there, our seasonings, our peppers. And then what are we gonna do next, Chloe?
Is put it in the blender.
Put it in the blender and give it to a nice puree, all right? Let's go ahead and get our blender going here. We have everything in here. We're gonna go ahead and put our top on. Thank you, Chloe. All right, and let's go ahead and give it a good blend. All right, now everything is nice. Pureed in there.
Pull it off here.
And then you're basically simply gonna pull it and put it into your stock and give it a good stir. Curry, you wanna get on the side of me so we can give it a good stir?
Yes.
Take your spoon right there. Oh, man, look at that goodness.
Good job.
Alright. While we're doing that, go ahead and give that a next couple things here we're gonna add is two things you can add. One is our heavy whipping cream. I'm gonna go ahead and add some of that there to our mix.
To make it a little bit thicker and
lighter. Yep. All right. Now some people like to add a little bourbon to their mix, but because I have a family of kids, let's not do that. So we're gonna omit that from the ingredient today. All right. So while that's doing its thing over there, last but not least, we do have our lobster meat that we need to go ahead and take care of. All right. So what we're gonna do, Chloe, is we're gonna go ahead and just chop up our lobster meat, a lobster tail. Yep. All that good stuff. And this is what we're going to use to put in the bottom of our bowls. All right, so now that we have our lobster ready, chopped up, go ahead and get your pan here. Go ahead.
Get all that oil.
Yeah. Little olive oil in there, little EVOO, I like to call it. All right, I'm just gonna go ahead and saute
the lobster piece in
All right, so now that our lobster is coming.
The main star of the show that's now gonna be eaten.
All right. If you wanna add a little extra pizzazz to it, throw a little garlic pepper on there. Just to give it a little bottom flavor, just enough. Smell that, Chloe?
I can still smell the steam, you know?
Yeah.
I can't smell it! Because I have a nose.
Alright, so now that everything is all sauteed here in our lobster, let's go ahead and plate it, Chloe, okay?
All right.
Now that you have it plated, just go ahead and take it over there, Chloe, okay? Thank you. All right, great. All right. I'm also gonna go ahead and bring over our lobster bisque. Here I come, Chloe, you ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
All right. Here we go. All righty.
There we go.
Here's your bisque, huh? All right.
Yes.
So last but not least, here's the good part, the best part, the taste. All right, so we take some chunks of our lobster, put that in the bottle. I'll do the same on daddy's side, just enough to coat, okay? All right, and let's go ahead and start scooping. Let's get a ladle. All right, and here is our ladle.
Uh-huh.
Let's get up in there.
Let's get it in.
All right, and one more.
This is gonna be delicious. I can't wait to try it.
All right, Chloe, here it is.
Yep.
So we have made our lobster bisque soup. All right, you ready to taste?
Yep.
Let's do it. It's a little warm. Let's blow it. Creamy. Delicious. What do you think?
Scrumptious.
Scrumptious? All right, great. High five. All right, guys. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching Chloe and Coco Mania. I'm Dad signing out. This is my girl Chloe signing out. We appreciate your time. Thanks for watching. And as always, smash that subscribe button. Bye.
Bye.